underway right now. Now, we don't have a timer on the link screen, but that's all right. We will. They're not too far off anyway, so we'll just pause that a little bit and should be good like that. On Grim's stream, I'm at 11, 12, 13.
Yeah, it's good.
Alrighty. So, more Dr. Mario action for today. I'm excited to see a lot of it happening this weekend. We have a. I just now noticed this with, like, all the groups that I arranged, but it seems that, like, a lot of people who played the NES Dr. Mario seem to be in this same group. Because we have Grim, Link, and Mitch, all who, when they have played Dr. Mario, they've played the NES versions. So it'll be interesting to see how they adapt to this version. I mean, granted, it's not too much different, but in terms of, I guess, RNG with the pills, you will notice a little bit of a difference.
Yeah, well, the games, like, the logic is the same, but there's a lot of differences, I feel, especially in the controls. The controls are way more fluid in the SNES version. So if they're used to tap the button, they won't be using the tap technique this time. They're playing the good version now. I'm sure they're going to have it. They're going to have trouble going back to the NES version after the tournament.
We will probably convert them permanently, and they'll never want to return to the NES one. It looks like Grim's timer froze on his stream, but that's all right. They're pretty much synced up right now, and we'll give, I can do a dot time in IRC to give us a time count every once in a while once they get to a certain level. I will get some music going on here, though. I don't know if Grim's using a microphone or not, but we'll enable audio on his stream.
Yeah, he's using music.
Yeah, he is. All right, time to bring up our own. No big deal there.
Nice. They're both playing very well right now. They're not doing many mistakes. Yeah, and Link has a very bad board because he has a lot of loops coming up, and like all these viruses are in like a tower, so this is he's gonna have trouble. Not his fault, but that's what happened in this game.
Yeah, as we've seen him many times before, just a little bit of a pill miscalculation can end up costing tons of seconds later on in that same level.
Yeah, when you misplace a pill, it takes usually like 5 or 6 pills to clean it up. So those 6 pills translate through like 3 or 4 seconds. So every mistake costs a lot of time. Alright, Grimmin is on sub 5 base, 405, that's pretty good.
It looks like it didn't take him too much to kind of transition over. I know, like, what, he used to have the world record for 0-20 in NES before ACM took it. And judging at his splits, he's got a 35 right now, which is very respectable. Only 5 minutes behind, well, 6 minutes behind what the world record is right now.
Yeah, he's gonna cause surprises in the tournament if he keeps playing. What he just did, like, he planned those red drops from the beginning. That was pretty good on his part.
And yeah, did manage to get the sub 5 there for the level 5. Pretty good pace for him right now.
And Link did good thinking there with his double already. That was pretty good. You need to plan those single color pills as much as you can. They are worth so much. can see that Grimmon has only one blue virus, but he's already planning to, or now he's good, but he was already planning a horizontal with the blues just in case he was getting bad luck. That's good thinking there.
He's got his next board. Looks like he could provide some pretty good setups too. I see a bunch of the reds that are at the bottom. All of them are grouped together in twos.
Yeah, that's what you want. Yeah, you want those virus in pairs, and he has a lot of pairs. Since he doesn't have a timer, do you know what's his PB for Link with Super 10? I haven't seen him play ever.
Let me see if I still have that document. I might have like thrown it away. But what I used a base seating on, I kind of just, if they didn't have a PB on the leaderboard, I looked at either past 0 to 10 or 0 to 20 race times. And I think maybe his 0 to 20 on NES was, I want to say, around 20 minutes. So, you know, not bad, considering he probably doesn't play the game all too much, I would say, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 0-10 translate probably like to maybe an 18 or a high 17. The game is slower on NES by a couple minutes.
So as a person myself not too experienced with the NES version, are those the big differences? It's like slower and the RNG is a bit different, or what are the key differences between the both?
Well, first of all, the pills seems more heavy. The control seems heavy, so there is lag every time you push your button to flip a pill. So you need to tap more, because if you tap, the pill is going to move faster. That's one of the key differences. And you are correct, the RNG seems kind of skewed to the yellow on the NES version. You can get like 10 or 12 single yellows in a row. That's pretty tough to play with. And it seems too that it's tougher in the late levels because the pills are going faster in the NES version. So if you make a mistake early in your level 20, you're gonna have trouble and you might be forced to game over. Like on medium, I think it takes like after 12 or 13 pills, you won't be able to push a pill on the top left or the top right of the board. And it's even worse on high. Like on high, I think it's like 9 pills. So you need to clean your size as fast as possible.
Gotcha. I can see why that can make a pretty huge difference in that game then.
Me, it's very frustrating to just like if your first row is only red and blues and you know I have no spots for yellows, it's almost always a good idea to just game over and restart.
I just love always referring to that highlight that ACM has on his channel where I think it was something like 40 pills before he got the color that he wanted. I'm like, oh yep. My gosh.
It can happen on the SNES version once in a while, but it seems to be worse on the NES. And I think it's one of the reasons why yellow seems to be weird in the SNES version. I think they probably use the same coding or some of it to code the SNES version.
Grimmon just with three more viruses to work with on his board. Looks like he's going to be able to clear that pretty quick there. Let's see.
Oh, that's a very fortunate double yellow that he got to clear the bottom yellows.
On Link's side.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit buried there, so pretty good awareness to see that that was his best move that he could do with that as well. So Grimm's timer was just around, I would say, 11:20 as he finished level 9, so I think that's pretty good odds to get a sub 13 maybe. Either that or somewhere in the low 13 range.
Oh yeah, sub 13 is definitely possible at this point, and his board is very good. I'm curious to see, to ask them what they think about this version. I think about it, but Link had a very good opportunity. If his blue red was just placed one row right, it could have been like a very huge combo. He thought about it, but I think it was a little too late. Oh, nice clear by Grimmon at the end.
Wait, did he, he did dock quit. You can do, hold on.
Unquit. Unquit and quit.
I mean, he has plenty of time to, fix the mistake.
That's pretty funny. He quit the race and then dot done. Yes, let's troll him a bit.
Yeah, I guess I don't think unquit works. Because it did not do it, yeah.
It's undone, yeah.
Yes, Link won. Also, oh, what's Lightning. Up, Lightning?
Like Mang.
Hello. I came in just to watch the end of that, and Grimmon's actually much superior final board.
I think he's still trying to figure out if he's doing the right command or not. But lucky for him, Link's still on like level 8 right now, so yeah, even if it takes him like 2 minutes to figure it out.
Oh man, that board is terrible. He's gonna need to have spots for yellows very fast. Like, he's gonna clear the yellow, but then the next thing he needs to do is to clear that blue on top of that yellow as fast as possible.
So I think we actually have ourselves a race right now to see if Link can finish or if...
Oh, and he,
Grimmon...
he
did it!
GG, sub 15.
Sub 15. Oh, he's blaming you on the misinformation there.
I said undone. Oh no, I said unquit. Oh, okay. Oh.
Yeah, they should both work, I guess, technically. I can't remember. Like, I never have to use the command, so I probably would have said it wrong too.
I actually hadn't heard of Link this before, so I was quite intrigued as to how this would turn out.
Yeah, as I was mentioning earlier, I'm not sure if you heard it, but this group kind of has like a bunch of guys that have played the NES version and not the SNES version before this. Like, Link's one of the guys who does the big 20s, along with Mitch that's in this group as well.
Oh, I see.
So it's cool. I know seeing, a lot of... It's cool seeing if, like, how they're adjusting to this version, and maybe we'll get to, like, talk to one of them afterward and see what they think of the version differences, if they like this one better or not.
I think they, if anything, you struggle with the speed a little bit more at the start, just because it feels a lot different. But I think that all the NES players, like, after a couple runs or so, they should be able to get into the groove with it.
Mm-hmm. I think it's way easier to go from NES to SNES than the other way around. And if you only played the NES version, the game will feel like smooth to you because that's the only thing you know. But when you touch another version like N64 or SNES, you're gonna see like it's two different worlds.
That was a good reaction by Link there when he made that.
Yeah, he was
plays with the yellow.
He's going to the big plays here. Let's see how he's gonna manage this. Alright, he got a double ready. He wanted probably. Okay. Like, I only played, like, I remember playing the NES version like back in the day, and like after like a year and a half of playing the SNES version, I just tried the NES version just for the heck of it. It's like, okay, I'm gonna just like complete a run, and I couldn't do it. I couldn't complete a run. It was painful. I think I managed to get one done, and I, just to say that I did one run. Alright, no, I did it.
I raced a lot of the people who were doing the big 20 last time around, and I was just joining in on a race for fun, and I just could not play the game at all. But you know, just going back to SNES, like this version is just—it's so much cleaner.
Yeah, me personally, I guess I'm a little bit younger than some of the people who grew up with like the NES and SNES, so I had Dr. Mario 64, and like ACM said in chat, both of those aren't too bad to like go back and forth between. At least my experience with N64, when I reversed and went back to SNES, it wasn't too hard to like kind of get the feel for it.
And to be honest, if everyone was like, if I would have like, if we had to choose one version, I think I would have chose the N64 because there is a timer in it. There's a timer in it too.
Mm-hmm. But I guess for ease of access with like how consistent SNES emulators are compared to N64 ones, this is a pretty good choice.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, I completely agree with the choice. But in my perfect world, it would be N64 probably.
Plus, I could listen to KK the whole time while playing, and then life would be great.
just play on the off and play it.
That is an option.
I mean, it's what you're doing right now, technically.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
I still haven't found the perfect songs to play with this game. And Link managed to clear his mess pretty good. It was scary for a second, but he managed to complete.
Yeah, I feel like he's having some trouble putting some pills where he wants them.
And his time finishes right above 20 minutes, so kind of what we were expecting a little bit.
Mm-hmm. This game is rough on new players because more pills you put on the board, the pills are getting faster, so you have less time to think. So it just becomes a vicious cycle at the end. You want to play good, but you don't have like the experience to just know where to place all the type of pills. So every time you get a pill, you think and place it, you think and place it, but at the end, you won't be able to think, you're just going to place it randomly or half randomly.
Or even worse is when you try and put something somewhere and then you just don't have enough time to put it where you want it to. And it just ends up being an obstacle.
Alright, looks like we're getting their record right now, and we'll be underway with the next level pretty shortly here.
Shoutouts to Ness pretty much being on top of almost every single race. He's been there ready to record at the ready.
Dang. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Lance doesn't play much, but he can pull some great times out of the blue. He plays this game a lot.
I think I remember seeing like early GDQ videos, maybe from like 2012 or even before that, of him doing races with Essentia. So he's definitely been playing this game competitively for a while. Ready. Race 2-3 underway. Well, potentially 3. Cool, they're still synced on my end. Lightning, did you want a timer count?
I'm just watching this stream.
Alright, sure.
I feel like getting set up, so.
Not a problem. There's not too much you can spoil with this game, anyway.
Good starts on both. Oh my god, what a great level 1 for Grimmin.
Yeah.
And he gets a double blue. 37 seconds is very fast. This is a great level 1 too for Link too.
Yeah.
He's gonna get the blues to drop down there and clear with only the yellows left to go there, and that'll be a sub minute for him as well. Much better than last time.
Like I said earlier, like on the NES version, you sometimes want to tap the D-pad to move the pill faster, and I feel like that's what Link is doing sometimes.
When you see it drop a little bit, and then...
I feel like he's tapping instead of just holding the D-pad down.
Solid 3 from Grimmin.
Oh yeah, like sub 2 at level 2 is very at 3 is very good. He's on a very good pace right now.
Now what Link did at the bottom with the blue red is what I feel that he's still not very comfortable doing combos. He's trying to set up almost all of his clears vertically.
Yeah.
It did end up working in his favor, though, when he did get that double red, and I believe that was three viruses that he cleared there. So I guess, unintentionally, it kind of helped him out. But yeah, definitely, he could have done that a different way to set up a earlier combo.
But he thought about that double yellow there. Oh, it's pretty good. And he's going to set up that double blue. Oh, he had a very big chance for the horizontal there with the double blue, but he didn't think of it. It's hard to think about horizontals.
Horizontals are really, really difficult.
You need to have a feel to it. Yeah, all these combos is all, yeah, almost always vertically.
And I kind of get it, because in the later levels, you don't want to set up horizontal combos waiting on a pill and then not get that pill. I think that's why, you know, different mindsets for different sets of levels is really important for this, much more than for the NES version, where everything is like, it's a lot slower paced, so you can just kind of like watch everything fall and not have issues.
And even at one point when you realize that horizontals are good, you're gonna mess it up often, because it's, if you go for horizontal and you do not get it, you're gonna waste so much time cleaning your mess. So you might say, oh no, that's the last time I'm gonna try a horizontal. So it takes a while to get used to it and keep going at it.
I'd like to give a shout out to you, Hippo, for that amazing pace spin.
Oh, thank you.
That, I think it's worth the read for everyone, because it helps me get into like a better mindset of setting up, you know, combos, or when I have pills that I just don't know where to put them.
Mm-hmm. Not only that, like, he's done two separate pace spins for the event, which you can find if you go down to the description of our channel and just click the challenge page. But yeah, very helpful for players who are beginning to learn about this game, and if you're trying to figure out advanced strategies and just trying to keep an open mind on what you should do, optimal placing, things like that.
I feel like even for advanced players, even though it's something that they should already know, it's still like kind of a nice to have if you ever take a break from the game.
Definitely agree.
Oh, you tried to squeeze that yellow, but it won't cost him that much time. I think his time is better now from the last race. Let's see. Oh yeah, he's way faster than last time.
Do you remember what his level 5 was last race?
It was like a very low 7, and now it's like a low 6.
Yeah, he seems to be just getting more comfortable with it, the game.
Yeah, I think it's the case of, like, not practicing too much, at least with this version, and, you know, even just, like, one attempt being really rusty, you know, the next attempt's gonna be a lot better. The problem he's dealing with right now is literally every single virus that's on top is a blue one, and I think he's kind of struggling to see what he can do with some of the pills that he's getting, and hopefully he can just clear some of those soon so he's not shuffling these like non-blue pills. But he did manage to get that yellow clear down there.
Now he's burying that yellow there. Okay, now I did already got the second double yellow we needed. Like, all these reds needs to be put on the lower red, on the like the lower right side. All the reds gonna be needs to get to be there. He keeps wanting to clear that red virus, but he needs to clear that non-red virus first to clear that yellow, because the yellow is very buried there.
think he's just ignoring the fact, like, all the blue pills that he is getting is attached to, like, a red or a yellow, and he's just sending it underneath, kind of, like, just ignoring the blues. Which is going to be bad upcoming here, because he's going to have that one solo yellow virus at the bottom, and just all these blues to deal with still on top.
Yeah. He needs to be working towards using his half blues to clear blues. I used to blame things like that on bad RNG, but now it's... I kind of feel like more than half the time, it's kind of my fault for not really observing the board at the start.
Yeah, I'm pretty bad at saying that it's RNG when I do a mistake or if I do a bad time. And will he see that big T? Already, he saw it. He saw it, the big T there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, very nice clear for him.
And he could do another T if he gets a blue red, he might. All right, he's gonna just give up. It's okay.
Yeah, but I know what you're talking about. The more and more that I play this game, when you first start off, you kind of only picture specific clears only possible. You know, you may be focusing on horizontals and verticals only and not really looking at specific combos, but if you open your mind, and especially after like watching what Ham was doing yesterday, it's like as long as you have so many viruses on your screen, you can do just about anything with any of the pills that you get. You just gotta like look further into it.
He has created kind of an ugly wall of single dots of red.
Yeah, now he needs to put that red flat. All right. Yeah. It's not that bad, but it's going to take a while to clear. And you got the big double blue here. That's going to help a lot. And if he gets a red-yellow, he could place that red-yellow vertically on the side of those three reds. Mm-hmm. Let's see if... Yeah, that's it. That's great. Now he can clear the yellow correctly.
If he would put a...
You can feel the wheels are turning fast in his head. Yeah. That's what I like about seeing like new players. You can feel the struggle. It looks like Grimmin is playing better than last time too. He's on low 12 pace.
He's starting to get very fluid.
Yeah, just the way he plays that double blue on the bottom. He didn't think about it, he just placed it.
Yeah, no hesitation. Now if that was me, I would have definitely rotated it the wrong way. Like sat on the next pill for like 10 seconds, wondering what I just did.
And this could be even a sub 12.
Yeah.
We'll be close.
Knowing exactly what pills he's looking for.
Yeah, it's a sub 12 on his timer, but it's 12:03 on the race bot.
Yeah, but race bot is generally a little bit slower because you hit your timer before that.
And he was just, he was like maybe 4 seconds on putting the dot done into the chat, but I'm sure he was aware that he was up by so much anyway that it didn't matter. And he beat his PB of 14:53 by 2 minutes.
Sick.
Ooh, hope that Grimm will take the match, though. 2-0, very convincing. I knew he was probably going to adjust pretty well transitioning from NES to SNES, and he's definitely proving his worth. Going to be able to compete with all the top people that are in this tournament.
Oh, yeah, he's going to be a force. When the bracket comes, he's going to be pretty tough opponent to beat.
So Lightning, you played Shazo earlier today, didn't you?
Nope.
Now, Shazo was someone I didn't have, like, a lot of information at all going into this tournament, but it looks like he took you to Game 3, so he's a pretty good competitor.
I feel like he has the ability to be very good, but he's extremely inconsistent. I feel like if he has a single bad board, or if he places a couple pillows poorly, he's unable to recover very well. Because the two times that I did beat him, it was pretty close. Or the one time that he beat me, I was pretty close, but the two times I beat him, it wasn't as close. So he's definitely able to pull off some good times. It's just kind of not having the controller flubs and not hesitating too much.
Gotcha. I bring that up because I believe, Hippo, you are going to be playing him after this match, if I'm correct.
It was in the plans, but Shazo has homework to do. So he postponed it on early next week.
That's fair enough. We have plenty of time. I didn't keep up. I guess that was happening probably right before this match. Or during
it was during it.
Yeah. I was hoping Thunder Mustache would show up. I'd like to get mine done as soon as possible so that I don't have to worry about scheduling within the next...
Yeah, same.
Yeah, I have one match to complete myself, too.
See, who do you have left?
I have Leniru, Ares' brother. Which, I'll be honest, I don't even know if he's, like, played the game before.
I feel like he is pretty involved with the puzzle community.
Yeah, he's involved, which is cool. I just don't think he, like, plays a lot. I think he just, like, enjoys us because, you know, he's friends with a lot of us, which I respect.
Now, I'm waiting for the Group D matches to start. That one's, I guess, other than your brother, Kananaphone is pretty well known for doing quite a few games, but...
Yeah, I haven't seen him in his, like, Dr. Mario expertise, I should say. Have you seen him tackle a little bit, I guess?
I haven't seen him play, but I'm very curious to see how he's going to go.
I've seen him play other games, and a lot of games he's pretty good at, but Dr. Mario, or any puzzle games in general, I have not seen him, so...
And then, as well as that, FFR Bros in that group as well, isn't he?
Yep.
Yeah, that's a pretty tough group to be in, actually, if Kananaphone, it, like, just excels, which I bet it's possible with the, like, amount of, like, speed gaming things I've seen him do.
Yeah, I believe he's fully capable of pulling out 14s, but at the way FFR has been practicing, and then knowing Ness probably gonna do pretty well, even with, you know, Rust and stuff.
Rust.
I think he's still gonna be, Ness is gonna be pretty safe through it.
Oh yeah, Ness won't have a problem until probably the quarterfinals, probably.
Yeah.
He's a very experienced player. Played this game a lot.
Yeah, for a long time. One of the most unique people, I guess, in this tournament, because he does, like, everything well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's a force to be reckoned with in, like, platformers, blind race.
Played so many games.
Yeah, and then even, like, Puzzle League and Tetris Attack, which I...
Oh, he is really good at those. If he's, like, actually well-polished in it, he could beat anyone on any given day.
Yeah, I mean, he is, like, as I said, you know, pretty rusty with those too, but he's not somebody we would take lightly in any Puzzle League game, so... And, you know, he's even better in Dr. Mario, so...
And he's not emotional. Like, if he does a mistake or gets bad RNG, you won't notice it in his voice or in his play.
Yeah. I feel like Link is trying to set up too many. Oh, that double yellow could.
Your voice is cutting out a little bit on my end, Lightning. I don't know if that's just me.
I'm kind of like moving away from my mic.
Yeah, I figured it was a little bit of like just sensitivity with Discord.
Yeah, I feel like Link is just trying to set up for those double blues on top, and I think he's finally given up on it.
Mm-hmm.
Speaking of like,
and it's done.
Yeah, GG to him. And what was that, 2015, which was 40 seconds faster than the other one. So, good stuff to him.
Yep.
And considering he was actually in a big 20 attempt before this, so he's been streaming for over 7 hours right now. So his focus to even get two 20-minute times is pretty impressive, considering he's played like 19 different games before this.
Wow. Yeah, he's a beast.
What I was mentioning earlier, I do see FFR Pro is in the chat with us. I don't know if he's here right now.
And yeah. That's answered your question.
Yep. If he was here, I was going to maybe bully him to race Ness right now, because I know Ness is kind of the dude who will just, like, race spontaneously rather than organize something beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Ness and me and Sean are mostly always out for a race. Just say race, I'm going to say yes probably every time.
Yeah, I think Ness is pretty involved with the Mystery Tournament right now, though. I've been with him in a few races. I'm going to do my plug for Mystery Tournament. If you've never joined it, you should join it. It's a lot of fun. You submit one game with a short goal. During the tournament, you draw games from the pool of games. So you're always playing games that you've never played before. If you do get a game that you have played before, yeah, you can redraw it for more randomness and
nice.
And this tournament happens twice a year, doesn't it?
Yes. There's one after AGDQ and one after SGDQ. So the signups usually open up like a month after each event, and you have maybe 2 to 3 weeks to sign up and get your games in, them approved, and enjoy the fun.
I have a mic now.
Hey, there's FFR.
Hey, you can hear me?
Yeah, yes. We can hear you.
Yay!
And a little bit more on top of the mystery stuff. Since it's a lot of the earlier rounds, we're kind of like trucking through a bunch of it now, but if you get on Speedruns Live, there's matches happening every day, and you can just watch personal streams. And then when they get to the top 8, they always stream that live on the Speedruns Live channel. So it's a really fun watch, and it's really fun. You can just join races even when you're not in the tournament.
And I do highly encourage you to just head up to irc.speedrunslive.com.
And I'm one of those guys. I've never even won a match in Mystery Tournament, but I have so much fun with it and join random races all the time. And it's cool because sometimes you find a game that you like a lot, and who knows, it could be your next speed game.
Yep. I actually picked up Crazy Creatures from it. Free world record, still available. I'm going to plug it every single time because nobody has played it except for me. So I've decided not to submit my easy time until somebody puts up a world record time.
That's fair enough. So FFR, are you available by any chance right now? Because we might be able to get a match, another match in if you would like to.
I guess I can set up my SNES and stuff.
That'd be pretty awesome. Let me talk to Ness and see if he's still on this channel. I don't know if he's doing mystery stuff.
If he is, I don't think he's in any races. Don't quote me on it.
Yeah, let's get Ness going.
Yeah, he said I could, sure.
Yeah, there we go.
Yep.
Nice.
I was like, I see the opportunity, might as well, since we already have the stream up right now. So I guess we will have another match of FFR Pro versus Ness Kamikaze, which are two people who are really skilled at this game, so it should be a really good watch.
What's your PB FFR on 0-10? Do you know it?
A 13:43.
All right.
But I'm still ready to get demolished anyways.
You never know.
Yeah, you really never know. With 0-10, sometimes you get some pretty good boards, the other person not so much, or you could just be playing out of your mind.
Yep.
Yeah, Ness did some 13s this week, so you have a shot.
Oh.
Alright, I guess we'll just rematch this channel then. It doesn't automatically enter the people, does it?
No.
Alright, we're good. Let's do it.
I still remember my match against Shazo. I had, no yellows for, 10 pills in a row, and I got really, really mad. 99% sure it affected my stage 10 play by a lot, because I was just getting pretty heated. There's one pill that appears either too much or not enough. I swear it's always yellow.
It's always yellow. It really is. Alright, so while we get set up for this next race, I don't know, feel free to talk about whatever. What are some of your favorite matches you've seen so far from the tournament? I'll start with you, Lightning.
I actually think this is my most anticipated match of the pools. As for matches that I saw,
for me it has to be Blue Bomber against, I think it was Alta Biscuit, where it was like a half a second win.
Oh yes. Yeah. There were many things in that match that went on.
Yeah, that level zero reset, that we need to highlight this, dude.
That was so good.
I cannot believe it. Did a mistake, reset, and clear level zero before his opponent.
I also feel like that one should have been retimed, but I guess he just quit and didn't want to play anymore.
Yeah, Alto was kind of just gave up. I'm sure, I think just by looking at it, it looked like Blue Bomber still had won. But I
retimed it and it was half a second, actually. It was a legit win in my book. And it's funny because he almost lost because he was one red away to beat the level, but it was weird that last virus couldn't go. He wasn't seeing what he could have done. It was so weird. We need to highlight the ending too.
Is the pressure getting to you?
Mm-hmm. Alright, what's FFR's stream?
FFR Pro 21. I'm not sure if he's live yet since he's probably just still setting up.
Yeah, I'm still kind of setting up a little bit. So I have to give you
a few more minutes.
Alright. I feel like a scrub, like, asking streams Twitch from people. Like, I don't have a clue.
That's fine.
I've been retired and unretired like 3 times in the past 18 months because I was playing the tournaments. I only come back because of the tournaments.
I saw Ham lurking about. He followed a whole bunch of people this morning.
Yeah, I got a follow from him, and I was like, Craigasm, dude.
I was really nervous. I'm like, this guy's going to judge me and how bad I am. I say that, but I don't think any Japanese speedrunner has ever been like that. Most of them are extremely courteous.
Yeah, not only that, but even like the Dr. Mario community, for as much as I've been in it, everyone seems really helpful and very nice. And it's really cool to be a part of right now.
I told Ham that he was a legend on Twitter, and he just replied by, "No, I'm no legend." And
that is something. I think it's just like the Japanese culture, where a lot of them are extremely humble about it.
They're definitely very respectful at any kind of like competitive games that they do, or just in general about anything in their culture.
Mm-hmm. And I think the friendliness of the community in Dr. Mario is almost because we were almost forever alone for the past 2-3 years. It's so cool to see new players to watch and play with.
Yeah, I've enjoyed it so much that there's a goal that I'm going for a tournament, but even once this is over, it's something I can just pick up and race with, just like I do with Puzzle League, because it's really cool to just, you know, hang out and talk with you guys and play some pills.
A puzzle game is just easy to pick up and re-pick up, like, even if you never practice, you just play and enjoy the game. Without strats and techniques and frame stuff, just pick up and build and kill some virus.
Yep. More drugs.
More trucks. That's the spirit. Is Ness's stream just Ness Kamikaze, or is he doing something else?
I'm pretty sure he's only Ness Kamikaze.
Okay.
He does have, like, the Simba channel.
Oh, it's true.
Yeah, so I guess he's just streaming on his.
That's fine. I figure I'm trying not to rush him because everyone is setting up literally at last second. One thing I might be doing at the end of the tournament, because I know Michael Mario brought this up to me before, I told him to just participate for the fun of it, but it looks like he's going on a trip for a month, so he's going to be able to finish group stage but not do single elim. So what I'm thinking is, look at the times for anyone who didn't qualify for bracket and whoever had like a higher average of times, giving them a second chance or redemption and letting them participate in the 0 to 20 stage.
Yeah, that's a pretty good idea.
Even better, you should get the 2 highest times and make them play a match.
That is
Oh
true.
My god.
Lightning, I like your ideas, dude.
Yeah, that way that way if somebody gets like stuck in a bad pool, like Kananaphone, and, you know, doesn't have the pressure of putting out a good time or something, they still have a chance.
Or like with Mr. Cab, when I played him, he busted out a 13 for 0 to 10. I ended up winning. But
yeah,
that's pretty impressive.
Mr. Cab was definitely a NES player. He did it for the Big 20, and you know, I told him you should just join this for fun, and then you know, he was like, "Oh, is this NES?"
And you just pull like 13s, like it's nothing. Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah,
there you go.
A lot of people did a lot of Dr. Mario practice for the Big 20 because it was the one game completely unlike any other.
Mm-hmm.
I'm here like, Karate Kid sucks like 10 times worse. What are you guys talking about? That game makes no sense. Like, things just fly at you and, you know, knock you into pits and then you just instantly die.
I realized when I played both of my mystery tournament matches, I've done like 5 in total, I think, this year. I'm actually joining some outside of my regular matches because I'm having a lot of fun. But I had to forfeit mm-hmm. both of the ones that I was in because the dude, whoever I played finished when I was just so far down, and like the continue systems weren't the greatest, so I was like, screw this. I had a Tasmania the first round. That was the worst game I've ever played in Mystery Tournament, for sure.
There are plenty of worse games to play in Mystery Tournament.
The second one, I just don't think I was getting the hang of. Like, I was just dying really easily. It was some NES game. I can't think of the name of it, but you can find it as, like, recently raced things.
Well, you should play Nazo no Murasame Joe.
No. No, thank you. I saw a little bit of that, and I was like, no thanks. What were the times that you guys both had?
I forfeited. Kira won with a 1 hour and 32 minute time.
Damn, you guys didn't redraw.
So, just to put it in perspective, Mystery Tournament goals are supposed to be 20, or I guess 15 minutes to 45 minutes long for the average player. This one was submitted with a 28 minute time estimate.
Hey, alright.
And usually at 1 hour and 15 minutes, both players are given the option to redraw because, you know, obviously you guys just suck too much, or, you know, if both players just don't feel like continuing after the 45 minute mark, both players can agree to redraw and just, like, wait out the time or something. But we decided not to, and that last castle was a... It was interesting. It's like maybe 10 screens of enemies and you're given 3 HP per life and 3 lives. And I just could not do it. We did not have a good time.